Hello everyone, FunctionX here. Welcome back to Crash Landing, a map pack on the Feed the Beast launcher and written by Iskandar. We're in version 1.1.2 and we are going to pick up right where we left off in the previous episode, which was about to craft that grinder. So let's get started.
Okay, now we can build this whole thing. First need the unassembled PCBs and the other circuits, if I know, remember where I put them. There they are, the capacitors. And we'll take 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Like that. And we should get 2 printed circuit boards. Now we can make our PRC logic board. Oops, if I had any plastic, I could. I need more plastic than that. Okay. Try that again. Make 2 of those. Let's make like just 1 machine frame right now. I put everything in here, didn't I? Try that again. Alright, Electrum, Glass, Invar, and Logic Expansion Card. Makes a machine frame. And now let's get everything else that's part of this stupid block. Here's a bug that you guys should know about. Well, it's not really a... Well, it kind of is a bug. If you go to the city and find a bookcase and break the chiseled version of the bookcases, you're going to get these weird books that are not ID340. They're going to be I340-7. So all you have to do is craft one book that's the right type, this 340, and throw all of your other bad books on the ground and pick them up with one of the good books in your inventory, and they'll all switch to the good books. So that's a little trick. It's on the forums. It's been posted quite a bit, but just in case you guys aren't up to date with the 220-something page forum post that this map pack has, there's a little tip for you. All right, we finally made the grinder. It's been a while since we did a quest reward, or a quest, but you can see we have now the grinder done. All right, let's look at the reactant dynamo and see if we can finish this quest. I'm not sure how much time we have, but let's go and look at what the components are and how hard it's going to be to do. All right, it's a lot of tinker's alloy ingots. Some transmission coil, which is silver and redstone, easy enough. Logic expansion card, which I just made, unless I just turned it into... No, okay, good. So this tinker's alloy is the same thing as bronze, apparently. Yeah, bronze around iron. Tinker's alloy is made with copper and tin. Okay, cool. Do we have any bronze left? We have 11. That's not going to be enough. So let's get 15 copper and 5 tin. That should be a good number. And we're going to throw these in the high oven. Actually, since we're not smelting ores, we can just go straight here. Or, do I want to go in the high oven? I think it would take longer. Yeah, probably just quicker to do it this way. The only reason really to use the high oven at this point is to multiply the ores 3 times if we're using the base materials. But once they're ingots, you don't get any multiplication anyway. So putting them in here is fine. I just have to wait. I gotta make sure these levers are all turned off. I don't want any of it to come out. Man, this copper is slow. Okay, guys, I'm gonna take a quick cut, make all the bronze that I need, and we'll go back and make this reactant dynamo. See you in a sec. All right, so we got our bronze. We are ready to go crafting up the reactant dynamo. So let's see the recipes here. We need 2 tin gears, which are just iron with bronze around them. And then we need 3 bronze, 2 gears here. Let's just do this. Silver. Did we get our silver? Is our silver done cooking yet? Should be in here. Ah, we never fired this thing up. Dang it. I was too concerned with getting the bronze, I forgot about the silver. All right, well, give that a go. Maybe since this is gonna take some time, I might just cook one silver bar in here. Start pouring out some more bronze too. I don't know, this might end up taking as long as this. We'll see. We'll have a race. No, we won't have a race. I'm just gonna cut here, guys, and be back as soon as this is done. Okay, the silver is done. It did finish faster in the smeltery, but we only got two instead of the three we're gonna get for all of these. So that's fine. Make me some silver, please. Come on. Where are you, silver? Took a while. Okay. Think we're ready to make that dynamo now. Silver with two redstone makes our transmission coil. Everything else should be good to go. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and the card. There we go, reactant dynamo. So this thing could take a solid fuel and a liquid fuel and mix them together and make power. And one of those liquid fuels that we can use is mob essence. And we just got a grinder which produces mob essence. So that's actually a pretty good little combo right there. All set up for us. So that's pretty cool. I need some more water. I'm going to run out of that water over here. Better move full time to the new base pretty soon. Okay, well, let's look at the quest book and see if that finished it off. It did. We were going to get some caver belts. Crap. Gunpowder. Crap. Mob essence bucket. That's pretty nice. That gets us our dynamo kind of started, and then we can power the grinder and then kind of infinitely work off that. And this unlocked two quests elsewhere. What did it unlock? It unlocked creating life. Nice. So two quests here. One is lonely, which is a repeatable quest where we make 10 buckets of mob essence into the QDS and an egg, which we have plenty of, and we get a guaranteed chicken. Cool. So we can take a chance with our eggs, like very small chance, or we can put some with some mob essence and get a guaranteed drop. That's cool. And then it looks like once we do the chicken, we can pretty much do anything. Cows, I don't know what all these are, probably wolves, ocelots, pigs, sheep, horses, villagers, and I think that's it. But cool. And then this one, oops, I forgot to look at this other one. It's kind of going to tell me to create a sink core. Since I took the hard rope, I don't have a shell constructor. So I think we do need to make one of these. Let's look at what is required for the shell. Shell constructor. All this stuff is easy. We need to go in the sink core. And this takes lapis and redstone and emeralds and a lot of nether quartz. We have the emeralds. We barely have enough lapis. Well, we have plenty of lapis, actually. We need the nether quartz. And I remember I told you before that comes from Seiving soul sand. Let's find it here just to make sure. Here we go. Soul sand. And soul sand comes from putting witch water. Sand in witch water, I believe. Yeah. So we need to get that all set up, which means we need mycelium. And to get a strange... Is it strange? No. What's it called? Oh, I just spelled the stupid thing wrong. No, I didn't. Spore? Ancient spore, that was it. Ancient spore is a 1% drop rate from sand. So we really need to get our auto sieving set up. So I think that's what we're going to do next. We need to take our cobble generation, take all that cobble, put it through a pulverizer, which we've already got, right? And then put it back to a pulverizer to make sand, and then we'll start sieving the sand. So let's get all that set up. I'm going to get everything ready that we need. The grinder. What should we do about the grinder? I could put it there, but it's not going to have power. I don't want to set up the whole power system right now with that reactant dynamo, so I'm going to put that on hold until we move to the new base. So put the grinder in there for now. Okay. Do I have any extra? Yeah, I do. I want to get this squid seed saved so I don't accidentally lose it. Although you see there's now squid spawning in that thing, that pool, because it's too deep. So again, as I said, give me a second to get this all situated. I'll probably build a new little area onto my base over by the city, and we will get auto-sieving done with Steve's Factory Manager as much as we can. Alrighty guys, I am back, and I've got everything we need to make this auto-sieving system work. First things first, I used all those extra furnaces. I put them to the use. I loaded them up with cobble. If I could talk, that would help. Loaded them with cobble and filled the fuel slot with a lava bucket, and that just burns forever. Right now I'm getting some more glass. But yeah, so I got a bunch of stacks of stone, and then I used that to build the area, which I'll show you in just a sec. You can see I've still got three more stacks of stone and three more stacks, or two, just over two stacks of stone brick ready to go for when we want to build more. I got all the silver out of this guy, and he's now cooking my iron for me, so I have a ton more iron, and I think we've got all we need. So let's go look at my inventory first in the bag, and then we'll head over there. What we've got? We've got our pulverizer, we've got our reactant dynamo, and we've got some hardened energy cell. I actually need to get some pipes, but I'll get there in a sec. Got a bunch of wood and a lever, some iron, some redstone, some aluminum, stone, cobble, gold, and a ton of inventory cable. So that's where I needed that glass for and my iron to make all that cable. So if you look at this, it's not too difficult. It is iron heavy and it is redstone heavy, but it's going to produce results really quickly and make up for that very fast. So I need to get some food to take with me. I think I'm just going to take, I don't know, should we cook up some tea? we've got apple. Let's make an applesauce. I know I can do applesauce. Where are you, applesauce? There you go. Applesauce is just an apple with a pot and a mixing bowl. Let's make a bunch of this. There we go. Tons of applesauce. You might have caught it by now. My coordinates are different. And you might have noticed my experience bar changed a little bit. And also my food hunger... diminishing returns on my food is not where it was before in Hunger Overhaul. I'm actually on a server now to offload some of the processing, I guess, to make it run faster. I mean, my videos have a higher FPS. So we are on a server running the game now. So that's why my base is in a different location. I had to just copy it out and paste it in there. Okay, this full chest is just about full, but I'm not seeing anything. Okay, leave that for another day. Let's get our glider and head on over. Okay, we've got all those components for Pneumaticraft. I am having a trouble talking tonight. Am I having a stroke? I don't think so. But I'm just slurring my words. Anyway, whatever. All that Pneumaticraft stuff, as I was saying, we want to use it soon, and it's hard just having it sit there and not putting it to use. We'll get there. As I've noted in the comments, though, in a couple of the videos, I don't want to skip ahead in Pneumaticraft just because we found the items in the city. Because some of you that are playing along probably haven't done a lot of Pneumaticraft, and you may not find the items in the city that I have. And so I want to kind of show how you do Pneumaticraft even if you don't find those things. And I think we have to craft them anyway as part of a quest. Okay, so here we are at the new ore processing building. It's just a framework here, but we are going to get it to work. So, you know what I forgot? The most important part, the cobble. Aw, man. Anyway, okay, and do I have a crafting table? I do have a crafting table. Let's go in here then and start doing some crafting. I'm going to block this up because I do not want to die. Take everything here and put it in my inventory. Okay. Get some plain old cobble and block this door off. All right, we should be safe unless a flying gas comes in. First thing we need to do is make some Java barrels. So Java barrel is, where are you? I don't think I brought enough slab wood. What if I turn? Can I? Do you have any wood? Hey, thank you. I needed that. okay, so let's get a bunch of this into planks. Make what? Maybe four chests. Yeah, actually, I'm gonna make five because I'll need some for a different purpose. We need five. Oh, got the five planks that we need. Perfect. Jungle wood. Exactly. I don't want to make five. Oh well. It just means I have to make another chest. Okay. Five Java barrels. Now I need a machine inventory manager, the brain of Steve's factory manager, which you guys have already seen me done, so I'm just going to craft this guy really fast. I did not want two pistons. Man, I'm having bad luck. Just one of those, please. Okay. And there we go. Alright, I'm going to stick the extra piston in here because obviously I don't need it. Okay, next thing we need is pulverizers I've got. I made an extra pulverizer, if you guys already saw that, because we're going to need two. One to make cobble into gravel, one make gravel into sand, and then we'll have dust as just a byproduct, and we don't really need dust anymore. We've got plenty of it around. I'm going to need three sieves for this setup, and of course I forgot my first one back at the base. We'll have to go grab that one. And I don't have enough string to make the other two sieves, so we're going to have to set up our mob grinder and try and get a lot of spiders in there so that we can get some more string. I need a rapid item valve from Steve's factory manager. This is basically like a vacuum hopper, but it works at like supersonic speeds. It's crazy. You guys are going to love how fast this thing works. But we need two hoppers and a dropper. Let's make the dropper. That thing's really easy to make. And let's make the hopper. Oops. There we go. I've got the two hoppers. And that should make that guy. And then we should be able to combine that with gold to make the rapid. You could just leave a normal item valve there, but it's just going to make it slower. So go with the rapid item valve. Next thing is three block gates. I only need one technically, but I want to process gravel, sand, and dust, and eventually soul sand, and you know, maybe some stone. So I really want as many block gates as I have sieves. I might as well just make all three right now, but we'll only be using one at the moment. So we need three iron pickaxes. Do I need more string or sticks? I do. Let's get 20 sticks. That should be enough. So, 1, 2, 3. Inventory's filling up. Can I sort, make it smaller? Oh, I got a little bit. What if I eat my donut? Then we can. There we go. Now I got room for it. Okay, and the block gate also needs three dispensers. I didn't grab the bow. Man, horrible. I forgot so many things. I don't have any string on me, do I, to make a bow? I know where one is. It's sitting in my chest because the skeletons have dropped them. Okay, so we can't finish that off. That's fine. So we'll just wait on the block gates. The next one's a redstone emitter. Right there. Whoops. One of those. And the last one is a redstone receiver from Steve's factory manager. One of those. Okay. Now we need lots of cable. I've got 42 cable left over. Let's put the torches away, maybe. Is that everything? You can have the stone and the cobbles. I don't need you anymore. All of you. Just go hang out in there for now. Okay, well, let's craft what we can, and then we'll go... Oh, I need to sleep first, actually. Craft what we can. We'll go back to the base to get the pieces that we missed. Gotta stay away from all the components. They're all hot. Alright, we better sleep here before the mobs start to spawn. Is it not night? Guess it's not night. Come on, son, go down. There we go. Come on. I hate when it doesn't work. Sometimes it just has trouble sleeping. There we go. Alright. Safe to go outside. Looks that way. Here's how we're going to organize this thing. We're going to have cable running all the way down the floor here. Oh, got more haste even. Sweet. I need to get auto repair on this thing pretty soon, though. It's running low. And we're going to have that inventory cable run all the way down here. We're also going to have it... I want to run it here. I'm just going to try and make a base, so I put my cobble gen downstairs, so it's not as hot. But I think I want all my barrels along this wall, and this would be storage for... I guess I could do it out one, or I could put it in the wall. Let's do it this way. This will work. And then we need factory manager. Going all under that. Okay. And then... go this way to get it connected to there. Using a little bit of extra cable, but it makes it look a little bit nicer, right? Cool. Awesome, looks good. Next thing to do is place down all our machines. Not there. So we're gonna have a hole in the ground right here, and this is where I will cobble will come up from the basement and store right there. Then we'll have gravel, sand, dust, and maybe eventually something else. We also need to have our output chest. And I think I did forget to craft one. Needed one more chest. All you fall on the ground for a sec, please, so I can have a chest. so much inventory. Alright. Did I get the chest? I did. Okay. And that'll be the output of all our dust and everything else. I'm going to make it a bigger chest eventually, but right now just a standard chest will work. Factory or inventory manager is going to go right here. Then I'm going to put a redstone emitter right here. And a redstone receiver on top of it. We'll put a lever on the receiver, and this is going to be our on-off system right there. It'll be off, or we'll turn it on. Okay, and then over here, we will take both of our pulverizers. Perfect. And I'm going to set those to be input from, I don't want to see these, so let's go input from the back and output out the bottom, both slots. Okay, and then over here we will have our block gates, which we couldn't make, so we'll do 1, 2, 3, and then right here, let's see, block gate, oh, I want to put that one, I don't need that one, I don't need 1, 2, 3, this one will be the rapid item valve. Right there, facing this way. And then I'm going to need the 3 block gates on top, right there. I can fill this back in. I dug too much out. Okay. And then one space in between, I'll have our sieves. So the sieves will be right along this path here. And then I'm going to hook up the block gates. So let's go right in the wall here. You can see it takes a lot of this cable. Okay, that should be everything we need. I'm going to take care of... well, I think I should go back to base and get everything we need. So we need our cobble generation set up. We'll move that over here. And then we'll need our some kind of cabling for this power. Eventually, I'll either use a reactor dynamo or something else. Maybe I'll pull power from there. For now, I'm just going to put this there and output out the bottom. Okay. We'll need our sieves and our dispenser. So I will be right back, guys. Just give me a second. Alrighty, guys, I'm back. I've got a sieve, so let's put our sieve right here. We're going to get a block gate, which I still need to craft. But I got my arrows. And I've got all this junk in here. Should I just make another one? It's easier. Use that as storage. Actually, I should just make a chest, is what I should do. Yeah, but then I got to move that all out. Yeah. There. Alright, so block gate. Here it is. Was the pickaxe, the dispenser, and the inventory. Dispenser is going to need my cobble. Got the bow, yep. I already have the bow. Come on, make a dispenser. I guess it won't because the bow doesn't stack. We're used to that by now, right, guys? Okay. And then you, one of you, one of you. There we go. All right, that should be everything we need, I hope. What I'm going to do now is use a system developed by VSWE and also shown on a recent Purple Mentat video. And I've changed around a little bit for my setup. But it's going to use the basic, same basic principles. So I'm going to go ahead and program because we're getting pretty long and you guys have seen me program this. I'll explain a few of the blocks that are new as I go. So be right back, guys, and we'll look at the program in action. All right, guys, we're back and ready to show the system off. It is all working great. We're just going to do sand for now. We'll add in gravel and dust later once I get more sieves. Okay, here's the program. We've got a pulverizing setup and a sieving setup. The pulverizing is a lot easier, so let's do it first. It's just a series of inputs and outputs. Gravel gen, all it does is it's a trigger, grabs from the first barrel the cobble, and puts it in the first pulverizer on the west side, which is the back. Pretty easy. Same thing with the sand generator. It grabs the gravel, which is in this better barrel, Java barrel, puts it gravel on the whitelist and outputs to the second pulverizer on the west and blacklisted. That takes care of taking everything. Whoops, getting dark. Don't want mobs to spawn around here. Let's see if can we sleep yet. Basically, that takes care of taking cobble out of here, putting it into here, and it takes care of taking gravel out of there and putting it into there. Right? Easy, easy thing to do. That's the power of Steve's factory manager. All right, so the next thing we need to do is we need to take the output and get it back. And remember, this could get gravel, a little bit of sand. This could get sand with a little bit of dust. And I've put them both on the bottom side, right? So here's how that is set up. We have get the gravel. It goes to both pulverizers because there might be, well, I guess there's only gravel in one, but it doesn't matter. Goes to both pulverizers, checks the bottom slot for gravel, and if there is, it just puts it back in the barrel, the gravel barrel. Pretty easy. Sand thing does the same thing as well. Oops. Checks both pulverizers on the bottom for sand and puts it back in the sand barrel. And the dust, exactly the same thing. Both things target the bottom, looking for dust, and puts it back in the barrel. So now we've got cobble and gravel going in, gravel, sand, and dust coming out. Pretty cool. All those are automated. Soon, or eventually, I might make a witch water setup to get soul sand. And I can put that in there. In this, I don't know, maybe another room, maybe second floor, something like that. Okay, so that's the pulverizing. Now we want to put in the sieve. And this is a lot more complicated because we're using blocks we haven't seen before. The block gate, the rapid item valve, the redstone emitter, the receiver, all that kind of stuff. Here's how it works. We're going to make it as simple as possible to understand. It's a pretty complicated flow. But just go through it one by one, pause the video, and you'll get to see how it works. Check out VSWE's tutorial as well, and Purple Mentat's also done a very similar thing. The key is this little block of three steps. This makes a rapid redstone pulse. I am on a server, and I'm not sure how it's going to handle that, but we shall see. The first thing you want to do here is have a trigger, and instead of just a standard one pulse trigger, whatever, you go into the connections, and you, instead of on interval, you change it to redstone controlled. That will add all these extra steps in here, and the only other thing you need to do is come into the receivers and choose your receiver, and that's it. Don't touch any of the other things. Add a flow, a 2-to-1 flow, and you don't have to do anything there but connect the on high pulse and on low pulse. Basically, that means whenever this thing receives a redstone signal, on the it's going to do a high pulse and then a low pulse. Both of those are going to send a signal to start this whole flow. And then on the emitter side, basically when we receive a redstone signal, we want to pulse the redstone emitter so it turns this guy off, and we'll pulse again so it turns him on, turn off, on, off, and we'll get a rapid redstone signal. That's how that those three blocks work. The emitter, all you need to do, choose your emitter and set the output to toggle. Okay, and we can see that real quick. Just if we turn it on, it's going to go blah blah blah. And you can see it's just a little bit, it's going so fast that the graphics can't even update it. But believe me, that's blinking once a tick. There we go. All right, next thing to do is we move to the actual putting the ingredients into the block gates. Right now I'm only doing sand, but I could easily connect all three of these, or just connect the one if I want to do gravel, whatever. This makes it really easy to control which one goes in. So I'm doing a 1-to-5 flow just so I can control up to 5 outputs. Only connected the sand for now. Get the sand, it goes to any barrel, really, doesn't matter, looking for sand. It's only going to find it in one, but I just didn't want to figure out which barrel it was when I was doing this, so that's easy, just select all the barrels. Then I say to the block gate, so I'm selecting the block gate there. Doesn't matter what side you pick, and we have blacklisted because we don't care what goes in there, we only have sand to go in. If I add all these flows, it is possible I might want to say only whitelist sand. Let's do that just to be safe, so we don't have the problems that we had inside the other building. Okay, so it's got the sand. It's put it in to block gate. You can't really have... There's no inventory here. The only thing you can do with this block is change where... Basically, this block right-clicks like an autonomous activator. You can change which direction it clicks by right-clicking on the block on a face. We want it pointed towards the sieve with one little space of... one gap right there. Okay. Next thing we do, we close that flow. So we're going to open it basically like this and then close it again. But I'm not going to hook up the gravel right now. There we go. And this flow will come, and this is how we get the items back. And that comes from the rapid item valve. If you look at this item valve, if you put their items there, it sucks them up if it's turned on, assuming it's turned on. It sucks them up, and then it's got an internal inventory, and you've got to store it somewhere. So this block gate, what it does is it either right clicks, but it also like drops the item as it's clicking. So if there's already sand in here and it tries to right click with sand, it just drops the sand. If there's gravel in here and it's got gravel, it just drops the gravel. So we kind of have to create a loop where we go get the sand, right click, and put it back through the item valve, back into the barrel, get it again, just this whole little loop thing. And that's what we're going to see here. In this one, it gets everything out of the rapid item valve right there. So I'm saying blacklist, nothing, so anything can go in here. Then I'm going to sort all the stuff. So the gravel, we know, goes into the second barrel there. And I'm whitelisting it for gravel. The sand goes into the third barrel, whitelisted for sand. Dust is the same way, fourth barrel, whitelisted for dust. And sort the rest basically says, go to my output chest and put everything else in there that didn't get sorted already. But just in case, I'm going to blacklist gravel, sand, and dust so it can't go in there. And that is it. It's not too complicated of a setup if you take it in little pieces. So here's a piece. Here's a piece, and then the sorting piece. All right, let's turn it on and see what happens. We don't really have any gravel or sand to work with right now. It's probably all sitting in here. Yep, it is. So let's turn it on, and you're going to see nothing happening because there's no sand in there to click with. If we turn this pulverizer on, however, we shall get some sand. I can put the dust in here. There we go. And you're going to see sand appear here, and this is going to get sieved. Look how fast it goes. It's crazy. It kind of goes, and then you don't even see what pops out because it's so fast. This item valve here, I can't even pick up the items, you know, that get sieved. You know how sometimes you walk by a sieve and you pick up all the junk? The reason I love this one so much better than on auto vacuum hopper is I can't even pick up these items. That rapid item valve is grabbing them so fast. Did I just... Oh, dang it, I got a limestone. Crap. Okay, if you're not standing on top of it, you won't grab them. But look, we're getting all this stuff. I got my exotic seed already. Oh, that's so awesome. Next episode, we're doing witch water. Look, we get cactus seeds already. That's a... And cocoa beans, those are low drop rates. What was cactus seeds drop rate? A 3% chance? Cocoa bean was 3%, and exotic seed was 2%. Oh, I need an ancient spore. Oh, I think exotic seed is for a jungle tree. I need the ancient spore. Maybe we'll get lucky. Hopefully we get lucky. I gotta increase the size of that chest pretty quick too. But that's all there is. I think one thing I wanted to fix is when I get this sand here, I only want to get one of it at a time, because there's no sense in getting a whole stack and then sending it all back into the barrel. So let's do a specific amount one, and then we won't see as many items. I don't know. They're still kind of all going through, cycling through, but... Cool. Yep, it's grabbing it and just throwing it through, like, super fast. Ah, that's awesome. It's just that same piece of sand going over and over and over again, and then it's kind of waiting for the next sand to come in before it generates the next one. So it's sieving it faster than the pulverizer can make it, which is pretty cool. I'm going to turn this off. And hopefully by the next episode, we have an ancient spore. That's pretty much it. I urge you, if you want to make this system, kind of pause, go back, rewind, look at it closely. If you have any questions, you can put them below, but you might just want to go to the forums and start a forum post, because I imagine there's going to be a lot of comments on this, and it's usually easier to track in a forum post. So go in the Feed the Beast forum, start a topic, and then let me know, hey, I've started a topic here, can you go reply to it? That might make be easier than tracking YouTube comments. But that's pretty much it. We've got auto sieving. All I need to do is make two more block gates, two more sieves, and I can automate our gravel, a sand, and dust sieving. And hopefully we end up with an ancient spore. Wish me luck. Till next time, guys. This has been Funshin X. Before I go, I really want to say welcome to all my new subscribers. I've gained, I think, 3,000 subs in the last 2 months. And it took me, my first 10,000 subs took me over 2 years. So this Crash Landing series is just great, you know, lifting my channel to new heights, and I'm really excited. Makes me crazy to see how many people watching each video, that you guys are enjoying this series so much. So just welcome all my new subs. Thank you for watching. Thank you for hitting that like button. That really helps me out. Until next time, it's been Funshin X. I'll catch you later. Bye.